Hi, welcome to this series of Pixar Rules of Storytelling for programmers, designers, and if you are a storyteller, come into the mix, because I'm also telling this for you. I have made a few videos about this, I hope you like them all. If you didn't saw the previous videos, I will leave a link in the card, just go watch them. The first video was a lot more for storytellers and a lot more in the storytelling perspective, but then the second and the third, I started deciding that I had to do this for designers, because that's what my goal was. So go watch it. So let's start with rule number 11. Whoa, we are far. We are right in the middle of our rules. Rule number 11. Putting it on paper lets you start fixing it. If it stays in your head, a perfect idea, you'll never share it with anyone. Oh yes, paper. You hear that right? Paper. No, and not only for storytellers. Also for programmers, also for designers. Putting your ideas on paper is really important. So first, write down your idea. Maybe even draw your idea. Just to get it out of your head, getting it on paper. And maybe you see if it works or not, you will. Then if you have different elements or characters or something, maybe take cards and put the characters or the functions or something like that on the back of the card. Maybe in front you write the name or draw the character. Putting it all on paper helps you to visualize your idea, to get it out of your head, to keep your idea in mind, to not forget your idea. Because brilliant ideas come and go, and we don't want them to go. So put it on paper. If you want a whole course about getting from an idea to realizing that idea and selling that idea, I can't wait to begin that course, but I'm not making it right now. In the future I make. But putting it on paper, that's the rule. Let's go to number 12. Discount the first thing that comes to mind. And the second, and the third, the fourth, fifth. Get the obvious out of the way. Surprise yourself. Oh, whoa. Don't discount everything. But what this rule means is that not every idea is a good idea. And your first idea is maybe not the best idea you have. Write down your first idea, but also write down your second, third, fourth, and fifth. Because there may be better if you just stick to your first idea. What chance do the other ideas have? You have to think about that. Some ideas are just good in your head and yes, I have this good first idea, I write it down. But are they good in real life? I don't know. That's why you have to put the first idea on paper, but also the second, third, and fourth, and fifth, and so on. Because you have to look at other ideas before you know if your first is actually better than others. Remember that. Also if you're making different designs and you have made your first design, maybe make a second design and a third design. Because maybe they are better. Maybe they are more beautiful. Maybe they are more user-friendly. But you don't know until you make those ideas. Make a lot of ideas. Combine the best elements, make again a lot of ideas with those best elements, combine them and work until you have a better idea than your first idea. Because your first idea, don't let it be your only idea, that won't be good. So, if you drew a lot of designs and your first design was actually the best, maybe leave a comment below. But no, I won't have a lot of comments if you only those people comment below. So maybe I'll comment below. But let's go to rule number 13. Give your characters opinions. Passive, mailable, might seem likable to you as you write, but it's poison to the audience. You think this is only for the writers? Think again. Change characters in this sentence to users. Yep, teams in programs is a thing, but I don't have talk about that. In a game, this means you have to make sure that different players with different playstyles can have all the same fun. But in, because everybody has a different playstyle, everybody is going to play this game in a different way and they all have to have fun. Yeah. But in other programs, this is also important. Google Calendar, for instance, is for some people to plan their week, for others to just keep for others to just not forget anything. And your program will be used in different ways, for different purposes. How can people use your program? Think about it. And Excel is used for a lot of things, for schoolwork, for calculations, for accountants, for to-do lists. Also to-do lists actually are a lot. To-do list apps are maybe for schoolwork, for deadlines, for just home tasks. Not everybody needs a date for his to-dos. Some people do need a date. Some people do need a reminder. Some people don't. Don't get me started of all the uses for Trello, because there are a lot. If you know how people can interact with your program, you maybe know how you want them to interact. If you don't want people to use your app as an alarm or calendar, restrict them. Don't let people do things with your app you don't want them to do. Don't let people do things with your game you don't want to do. Don't let people go to somewhere and spawn items for an hour, because that's not fun. Restrict them where you need, but don't restrict them too much. If you restrict them again too much, it only takes away the fun. Let them have your own choices, their own choices, their own opinions, their own strategies, or their own uses. It's okay to do that. Maybe Scratch isn't made for just making stories and little videos, but should they really restrict them? Should they? I don't think so. Well, and here comes the end of this video. If you like this video, leave a like. If you want to see more videos about realizing your idea, making your program happen, we are making videos for people who want to realize their idea, their game, their program. So maybe subscribe if you want to get in that mix. See you next week. Bye!